Good day, welcome back to Portland Meadows Racing Live Track Handicapper Matt Jukic joining you once again, looking at the Wednesday, November 28th program here at Portland Meadows. 10 race program on tap. We do have a couple of pick fours, first four races, last four races, both have that 14% takeout. Let's get right into it. We're going to take a couple in the first race. The three, look at Maddie Go, and the five, Janie's Demon. They were in a photo last out, separated by just a nose between them. I think we're going to take them both in this spot. I think they are the ones to beat. If I had a favorite one, maybe look at Maddie Go, just because this one's going to get first run on the late running Janie's Demon, who might just get too far back. Janie's Demon, sorry. There should be some speed on in there. Early Habit will be out on the front end. Molly Weiss shouldn't be too far away either. Maybe even Coco Monkey has shown some speed in the past, so I think we will be able to wear out the front runners and hopefully get our two picks up. That's the three and the five. Into the second race, two horses again, the three Most Flashy Date and the four My Man's No Lady. My Man's No Lady has been sensational since showing up here at Portland Meadows. Two wins from two tries, both of them really in blowout fashion too. The first one by almost 11 lengths in the end, the second by an easy 3 1/4. So I think the sky's the limit here at Portland for My Man's No Lady. They've been just kind of taking their time with this one and putting him in the right spot. So you can see, first time went off at 8-1. Next time favorite, shouldn't be too far away from favorite, isn't today. So Most Flashy Date, I guess if you wanted to knock him, no wins over at Fast Track. 0-7, but 5 runner-up finishes and a third. So there's some quality there. 6-time winner over the wet strip. So have a look at the weather forecast, but Most Flashy Date should be involved. A winner of 3 straight races. Into the third race, we're going to cover 3 in here. The 2, the 5, and the 8. That's Wind Shadows, Native Chum, and the outside horse in Cousin Eddie. Really didn't get a great feel for this event. You get some horses going from sprint to route. Some horses who have been showing kind of inconsistent form going along. So we're going to have to take a few and hope that we can get something home in this one. The 2, Wind Shadows, second time going a mile. Or second time going a mile or further, I guess. Mile last time out was well back. 17 lengths back of the first call. Came with a big run to finish third that day. I think the extra ground and just keeping in contact with the field will help out Wind Shadows. The 5, Native Chum, is coming off a maiden breaking score. Not a very high buyer, but the best thing I like about this one is the trainer going sprint to route has hit with 4 of his last 6, 67%. That's massive in horse racing. So we'll see if Lynn Homer can keep that rolling here. Native Chum is one we're going to toss in. The 8, Cousin Eddie. May have tried a bit too tough in that Spirit Mountain Casino sort of handicap there. Ziggy Zack, all about Jake Mazama. I think actually he's a better horse going long. We'll see if he can prove that in here. Into the fourth race, we're going to cover the 4 and the 7. I like the 4 a bit in here. And CeCe trying to beat the boys. Had her first race in almost a year last time out. And she ran third to a decent field there with Iconic Choice, Needle Juanita. I think there was tons of room for improvement here. If she can run back to any of those other races where she was buyering in the mid-50s, I think this level, the D-value level of 1600 should be no problem for her. I think CeCe is alive in there, especially with the Bug Boy on. We'll see if that week coming off will help her out. I think the 7th Street Drive is worth a mulligan after that last one. He just tends to do that. He'll run a couple good races, and then he just runs where you just throw your hands up and say, all right, forget about it, let's move on. I think Street Jive could be sitting on a big one as well. Another one that just kind of tends to be wind shy over Fast Trip, so again, check that weather forecast before getting down, or the forecast, actually, that day. So it's a 3 and 5 with the 3 and 4 with the 2, 5 and 8 with the 4 and the 7. $24 gets you in that first pick 4. But like I said, it is Wednesday, so we do get 2. We've got to skip a couple of races off into the 7th race. $2,500 claiming event for the gals at Alora. And a Lurie Girl. I think a Lurie Girl is in a much better spot if you take it on the boys in her last two in the rope claiming series. Found herself up on the lead last out, dueling with a couple others. I don't think she wanted to be there at all. I think she's a better horse coming from just off the pace. Hopefully she can get a good trip in this one. Adalora had a very rough trip. Had a 3-2 favorite last out. Was off a little slow, was wide on the turn, really lost all chance. I think getting back to a mile, which is really her game, helps her out immensely. Into the 8th race, I think our best bet of the day will be South Carson. Really not a ton in here that he'll have to beat. If you wanted to make it for somebody else, I think you make it for Buckaree. Lynn Homer had this horse entered on Sunday. Did actually scratch out of this one out of Sunday to run here because that other horse that they had entered did win with Joe Crispin aboard. Joe Crispin shows up back here. They've had a very good meet together, so I think it might be a sign. You might want to cover him. It's a 4-year-old making that first start late in the year, so if you wanted to take one South Carson, I think we should take two anyways. We're going to throw in Buckaree just in case. Into the 9th race, 1, 2, and 4 for me. I guess the big question is, what do you do with the 2, 18 Irish? I don't trust this horse one bit. You can see does tend to win. He's won a couple in his career, but he won at 2-5, a few starts back, and even before that at 3-2. So really not a whole lot of value when he wins, but he tends to go down in flames quite a few times. You can see a 3-5 beat, a 3-2 beat, so always takes money. Doesn't always show up with a great effort. So 18 Irish, I think one you have to cover. I don't think it's one you can lean on, though. I think Classic Chumbery is coming around in the right direction. Second start off the bench for that aforementioned Lynn Homer Barn. Joel Crispin, of course, riding for this one. And for Camilchi Magic, just two starts so far, but both have been very good with second in the debut. Do Classic Chumbery and then came back to easily break his maiden next time out. I think that we could see a little more from him today. Into the last, the one and the three, no balls, two strikes. And Tequila Reserve, no balls, two strikes, riding nice two-race win streak into this one. Good to see a little flexibility in his running style last year. Able to sit behind horses, make that one move, and get by them. He's a three-time winner here at Portland from seven starts, so he should be around late. Three, Tequila Reserve, another one coming off a win. This guy's 7-9 in the money at Portland. Just seems to be a solid competitor. He's got a mark in each spot going this far. So it's a 1-6 with the 5-6, with the 1-2-4, with the 1-3. That's $24 in that late pick four. Maybe we can get lucky.